In this video, I'm going to walk through developing a dashboard with Yellowfin's Freeform Canvas. In a typical business intelligence tool, when you put together a new dashboard, you're going to be locked into a kind of row column system, and then you take your objects, your reports, and you drop them into the tiles that are in that setup grid. Yellowfin can operate that way too, but by default, it allows you to use a freeform canvas, which pixel by pixel, you can set the content where you want to set it. So for example, if we want to go into, say, a categorical detail with drill down, we can resize it, we can move it freely around, and set it up in any fashion that we want around the other artifacts that we're putting onto the dashboard. Now, maybe for this other one, we could even make a report. We'll do something like, let's put it here and then set it up as account segment. And we'll do that by total sales. Now we set this report. Again, we can widen it. We can set it the same width as the other report. We can put other content over here. And that other content, interestingly enough, along with this freeform canvas, notice that Yellowfin gives us an almost Adobe Illustrator feel in terms of content design. So you can come over, in addition to the reports that I've dropped in here, and you could put in, say, filters that link together. And I showed those in another video. You can put together text, pretty much stylized text for titles and paragraph bodies and things. And then graphics. So you've got your shapes here. If you want to, say, set up chevrons to draw attention to a particular graphic or piece of data, images from the Yellowfin Image Manager. And then you've also got widgets that are predefined here but can be extended. So things like video or even custom HTML can be put into these canvases. So the flexibility is pretty extraordinary. Now, in addition to having these reports on this canvas, I want to also be able to link some interactions together that are beyond filters. So for example, this supports drill down. So I want to be able to filter this based on my interactions with another report here. And so in order to do that, I'm going to go over to Link Interactions, and I'm going to take the report that I'm going to click on and select product category in the target report. So now when I drill down on this, it's going to link to this field, and that link will cause the other report to be filtered. So I can go ahead and publish this now. Save it into my tutorial folder, give it a meaningful name. And now when I go in to do a drill down, I can start to analyze things like, I've got a product here that I want to zoom into, and I've got a size of the store, the retail store outlet that they were sold in. And so if I want to see, for example, overall, that smaller stores had a much higher volume of sales, I can go product by product now and take a look at that and see, for whiskeys, it's true as well. But what about, say, for rums? Yeah, true again. Gins? Oh, now large stores went out. So by product by product, I'm able to go through and actually get contextual analysis along with the summary analysis I'm getting in another report. I'm clicking on this report to filter this one. And that is an easy way to put together interactions in what can also be these highly stylized canvas style dashboards.